Amoxiklav is a broad-spectrum antibacterial agent that has a bactericidal effect. Amoxiklav is a combination of amoxicillin and clavulanic acid. Indications: infections caused by susceptible strains of microorganisms. Upper respiratory tract and head organs, including acute and chronic sinusitis, acute and chronic otitis media, pharyngeal abscess, tonsillitis, pharyngitis. Lower respiratory tract, including acute bronchitis with bacterial superinfection, chronic bronchitis, pneumonia. Urinary tract, cystitis, urethritis, pyelonephritis. In gynecology, skin and soft tissues, including human and animal bites. Bone and connective tissue, biliary tract, cholecystitis, cholangitis, odontogenic. For powder solution for intravenous administration additionally, infections of the abdominal cavity, sexual transmitted infections, gonorrhea, chancre. Prevention of infections after surgical interventions. How to use intravenously. Children weighing less than 40 kg, the dose is calculated depending on body weight. Less than 3 months with a body weight less than 4 kg, 30 mg per kg in terms of the entire drug amoxiklav every 12 hours. Less than 3 months with a body weight of more than 4 kg, 30 mg per kg in terms of the entire drug amoxiklav every 8 hours. In children younger than 3 months, amoxiklav should be administered slowly by infusion over 30 to 40 minutes. Children from 3 months to 12 years, 30 mg per kg in terms of the entire drug amoxiklav with an interval of 8 hours. In case of severe infection, with an interval of 6 hours. Each 30 mg of amoxiklav contains 25 mg of amoxicillin and 5 mg of clavulanic acid. Adults and children over 12 years of age are weighing more than 40 kg. 1.2 grams of the drug, 1000 plus 200 mg with an interval of 8 hours in case of severe infection with an interval of 6 hours. Prophylactic doses for surgical interventions. 1.2 grams during induction anesthesia with an operation duration of less than 2 hours. For lunch operations, 1.2 grams up to 4 times a day. For patients with renal insufficiency, the dose and or interval between administration of the drug should be adjusted depending on the degree of insufficiency. Since 85% of the drug is removed by hemodialysis, the usual dose of amoxiklav must be administered at the end of each hemodialysis session. With peritoneal dialysis, dose adjustment is not required. The course of treatment is 5 to 14 days. The duration of the course of treatment is determined by the attending physician. With a decrease in the severity of symptoms, a transition to oral forms of amoxiklav is recommended to continue therapy. Preparation of solution for intravenous injection. Dissolve the contents of the vial in the water for injection. 600 mg, 500 plus 100 mg and 10 ml of water for injection. Or 1.2 grams, 1000 plus 200 mg in 20 ml of water for injection. Intravenous injection and slowly, within 3 to 4 minutes. Amoxiklav should be administered within 20 minutes of preparing intravenous solutions. Preparation of solutions for intravenous infusion. For infusion administration of the drug amoxiklav, future dilution is necessary. Prepared solutions containing 600 mg, 500 mg plus 100 mg, or 1.2 grams, 1000 plus 200 mg of the drug should be diluted in 50 or 100 ml of the infusion solution, respectively. The duration of the infusion is 30 to 40 minutes. Amoxiklav solution must not be mixed with dextrose, dextrin, or sodium bicarbonate solutions. Only clear solutions should be used. Prepared solutions should not be frozen. Contraindications. Hypersensitivity to the component of the drug, hypersensitivity to penicillins, cephalosporins and other beta-lactam antibiotics in history, cholestatic jaundice and or other abnormal liver function caused by taking amoxicillin, clavulanic acid in history, infectious mononucleosis and lymphocytic leukemia. Special instructions. During the course of treatment, it is necessary to monitor the state of the function of the hematopoietic organs, liver, kidneys. In patients with severely impaired renal function, an adequate dose adjustment or an increase in the intervals between doses is required. Perhaps the development of superinfection due to the growth of microflora insensitive to it, which requires a corresponding change in antibiotic therapy. In patients with hypersensitivity to penicillins, cross-allergic reactions with cephalosporin antibiotics are possible. During pregnancy and lactation, the drug is used only if the intended benefit to the mother outweighs the potential risk of the fetus and child. Side effects. From the digestive system, loss of appetite, nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, abdominal pain, gastritis, stomatitis, glossitis, black hairy tongue, darkening of tooth enamel, hemorrhagic colitis, may also develop after therapy, enterocolitis, pseudomembranous colitis, violation liver function, liver failure, more often in elderly men with long-term therapy, cholestatic jaundice, hepatitis, allergic reactions, itching, urticaria, erythematous rash, erythema multiforme, angioedema, anaphylactic shock, allergic vasculitis, exfoliative dermatitis, Stevens-Johnson syndrome, acute generalized infirmatous pustulosis, a syndrome similar to a serum sickness, toxic epidermal necrolysis. From the hematopoietic and lymphatic systems, reversible leukopenia, including neutropenia, thrombocytopenia, hemolytic anemia, reversible increase in PT when used together with anticoagulants, reversible increase in bleeding time, eosinophilia, pancytopenia, thrombocytosis, agranulocytosis. From the site of the central nervous system, dizziness, headache, convulsions, may occur in patients with impaired renal function when taking high doses of the drug. From the urinary system, interstitial nephritis, crystalluria, hematuria, others, candidiasis and other types of superinfection.